In this video, we are going to explore two simple yet very powerful text animation techniques. This will give you so much more control when creating text animation in After Effects. In this first example, we are going to create something interesting with this text by isolating one of the letters and then animating it. To get started, I'm going to go over this simple text in here and I'm going to open it up. And under text in here, you will find this button here, animate, and then arrow next to it. Let's click on that and we are going to click on position. Now I'm going to adjust its Y axis, its Y value to something perfect. And if I open this in here, range selector, from here, we can see that we have start and end offset. With this, we can choose which letters are animated. And like this, I'm going to isolate by sliding the slider, I'm going to isolate D0 from here. Now, with this, I'm also going to add, from here, we can add other properties that we can animate, and I'm going to add a scale. So now, if I close the range selector, I can see they have a position and a scale. If I resize this, you can see that only that letter will resize, just like that. Perfect. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to unlink this so that I can affect the Y only of this. And I'm going to start animating this. I'm going to do a very simple animation here, a bounce animation, to do this interesting animation with this text. So I'm going to toggle on the stopwatch from here. Now I'm going to go, let's zoom in a little bit and maybe at a half a second in here, bring these keyframes right over here. And at the start, I'm going to start this from zero so that it starts from the bottom right over here. And in here, I'm going to increase its length just like that. Make sure that you have a keyframe in here. So let's type in 100 in there. And now you can see that being animated with these keyframes. Now I'm simply going to copy these keyframes in here and paste them right over there. And I'm going to decrease the size of this just a little bit so that when it bounces, it will kind of fall and squash a little bit in there. We're almost done with this. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add some easing in this. So I'm going to open the graph editor. Don't worry, this is going to be very simple. I'm going to create an easy ease in the middle in here. And I'm going to pick, make sure that all the keyframes are selected in here. Pick one of these handles and stretch it just like that. Make sure that all the handles have been selected. And I'm going to stretch it just like that as well. This way, when it goes up, it will slow down. When you see this, like this is more horizontal, the line, it will be slower. And when it is more vertical, like this, more steep, the curve, it will be faster. So in the beginning, right now, I'm going to make it very steep so that the animation happens really fast, just like that. And in the end, the same thing in here, I'm going to make it very steep so that the animation ends up fast. So let's play that and see how that works. Wonderful. So now I'm just simply going to copy this and paste it again. And let's see how that looks. Wonderful. So you can see how it is bouncing like that. We can easily create a loop expression in here to keep this looping, or else we can even, if you don't want to go into expressions, we can even copy those and paste them to the length that we would like. And if we end the composition at around here, you can immediately see this effect, which creates this nice bounce effect over our text. Great. So right now I'm seeing that the B of bounce is being affected just a little bit. So I can go into the range selector and make sure that that is isolated. And now we can see only the zero of the bounce, the O of the bounce in there. Perfect. So that was the first example. Now, if we jump into the second example, this is going to be very interesting as well. So we have this text, windy, and I would like to create something interesting with this text where it kind of flows with the wind. How we can do that? We're going to take a completely new approach, but it's going to be very simple. So first of all, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick this, the pen tool in here, pick the text and draw a line over this with 1 point at the beginning, 1 point at around the middle. I'm going to keep holding this to drag the handles out, just like that, and 1 point at the end. I'm holding shift on my keyboard so that it is aligned perfectly, just like that. Wonderful. So now I'm going to open this up, go to text, and from path options under text, I'm going to choose mask one. And you will immediately see what this does. If I pick the selection tool and I move one of the handles, you can see that now the text is tied with that mask. That's really great. So now to animate this, we're going to use a trick in here. So let's close this and find the mask. This is mask one in here. As you can see before, in path options, we have chosen that mask in here from mask one. So let's go to mask one. I'm going to pick the mask path, which is actually the path that we have created. And then from window, we're going to go to create nulls from paths, and this will open a little plugin for us, a little script. So, and now we're going to click points follow nulls. And we can close this now, and you can see that it has created three null layers for us. And if we move these null layers, you can see that now that mask, that those points of the mask will follow that null layer. The middle will follow this, and the first part will follow this. This gives us so much flexibility, as you can see. With that done, we can now animate the null. So I'm just simply going to hide the first two and only work on null six, this one. So let's open that up. And I'm going to hit P on my keyboard to open the position property. And I'm going to right click on this and click on separate dimensions so that we isolate the X from the Y position, just like that. And I'm only going to animate the Y position. And I'm going to animate this using a simple expression called a wiggle expression. So option or alt click on your keyboard while holding alt click the stopwatch to open the expressions. And in here, I'm going to type wiggle. And you can see that it creates it for us in here. Double click on that. And I'm going to create something like four, which means the animation will happen 4 times per second. And then something like a 50, I think, would be good. And 50 would be the position that will be affected, the value. Let's see what we have created in there. Hit zero on your keyboard to preview. And great. You can see that it is creating this animation. Really great. So I can increase this to maybe 150 to make it a little bit more visible. Really great. And what I can do, I can even make it faster if I would like, just like that. And you can play with this to create whatever you like, basically. So let's make it 5. This one and this make it 100, just like that. And I quite like this. The only thing that I'm going to change is I'm going to go inside the text. And from, if I close the mask in here, from path options, you can see that you have some settings in here. Choose forced alignment. I'm going to turn it on. And this will hold the alignment of the letters with the mask path so that the first letter doesn't move in here. And you can see how that works. Really great. And you can immediately see the flexibility that this technique gives you to create your text animations and make them look interesting right inside of After Effects. So that's it, guys. I hope that you found this tutorial interesting. Of course, don't forget to hit like and subscribe to this channel, where we will be releasing more videos to help you out in your After Effects journey. Thank you for watching.